release. No, it doesn't.
It does.
Well, I better take these glasses off, but I've got my safety gear on, see, I've got my yellow jacket, got my helmet and my glasses, but I can't see a bloody thing. Here we are. I'll start with a bit of irony, you know. How do you burn an Irishman's ear? Well, you ring him up when he's ironing. So he answers the phone, he burns his ear, but I've got my safety helmet on. How do you get him to burn the other ear? Get him to call the ambulance. Now, we live in a bit of a strange world here. We've got a world where I've gone into Oz. I'm following the yellow brick road, but my name's not Jeffrey, thank God. You saw him at the races, didn't you? And we're here and we're building this big tunnel. It's just down there. And we've got the East-West Consortium. We've got the Wicked Witch of the East and the Wicked Witch of the West, and they want to join up and put a tunnel under our cemetery. And a whole lot of lawyers got together and they had a bit of a problem with how deep they could dig the tunnel. And they decided 30 metres. 30 metres. And it wasn't going to upset all those ghosts that are living over there. How did they prove that? Well, I don't know, they're going to suck it and see. But I'm very, very worried because I've got a ghost in my house and when these guys get upset, they're all going to move out. And they're going to camp in various places. And it's going to create bloody mayhem. People are going to have to sell their houses, they're going to get divorced, but it'll make a lot of money for our legal profession. And there's three guys, they went hunting. It was a lawyer, a doctor, and an engineer. And they had three dogs, and they liked their dogs, and they're very proud of them. They walked through the forest all morning, and in the afternoon they came to a clearing. And there was a great big pile of bones. And the doctor said to his dog, and his dog was, I can't remember the name, the guy that invented penicillin, was his name, Howard. He said, go and fix the bones. So the dog runs over and he builds a perfect skeleton. And the doctor's very proud of his dog, gives him a big pat. And the engineer says, see what my dog can do. Calls his dog over, his dog's called Newton. He says, Newton, go and fix those bones. And Newton goes over and he builds a perfect replica of the Sydney Opera House. Fantastic. And the lawyer and the engineer's as proud as punch. Anyway, the lawyer says, come and see what my dog can do. He's got this big black Rottweiler. And he calls his dog over and says, come over here, Lucifer, come and fix those bones. The dog goes over, he eats half the bones, buries the other half, screws the two dogs and goes to sleep for the afternoon. Lovely fellows. Well, I'm a bit lost, sorry. I have to have a little pause. But you know about the Wizard of Oz and the three main characters. We have a scarecrow, a tin man, and a gutless lion. And I've got this idea, you know, to save Australia, and I'm going to tell Tony about it. And Tony, he's going to announce to the nation this great plan of building the biggest bollard line in the world. It's going to run from Adelaide to Darwin and from Brisbane to Broome. It'll be manned every half a kilometre by a man wearing a yellow jacket with a stop and go sign. And to help the solar industry, it'll put a solar light on top of every bollard. And when you photograph it from space, we'll prove that Australia is a Christian country.
Big solar cross.
But
is that what it is?
Big solar thing. But we've also got, we've got a situation at the moment where people come to Australia, they come on boats, on wooden boats, and our wonderful foreign minister, a bishop, they call her the asbestos queen, by the way. She held up the asbestos case for 10 years until the victims died. But she's offered the Cambodian government $40,000 per person to take these people to the place where the worst genocide in my life occurred. There was a million people died there. But there were three people and they were sitting on a log. There was a Biafran, an Australian bishop, and a gentleman from the IMF. Oh, I think it's a bloke that liked maids. And a fly came along and landed on the IMF's banker's nose, and he shooed it away. And then it landed on the Australian's nose. And she pushed it away. And it came near the Biafran, and he grabbed the fly and he ate it. And another fly came along, landed next to the IMF guy, and he grabbed the fly and he said to the Biafran, "I can give you a loan so you can buy this fly." And the bishop, the Australian bishop, said, "Look, I can do one better. I can get a refugee, give your government $40,000, and by the time they've gone through all the corruption, you'll have enough money to actually buy that fly." But another thing that worries me is about our Prime Minister, and he's stated that he wants to go and shirt front one of the most powerful men in the world, Vladimir. And I've been sitting up in Collingwood there for about 16 years, and I've seen quite a few things. I've seen what shirt fronting really is. It's when someone's had a few drinks too many and they get very emotional. And what they do is they rip their shirt off like this, and then they start punching on and they go, "You fucking dog!" No. That distresses me because I don't think that's the way I would like to see my Prime Minister behave. Just talking about lawyers again, he's a lawyer as well, so we've got a whole lot of them. Hockey's a lawyer, Abbott's a lawyer, Bishop's a lawyer, the other Bishop's a lawyer. They all have that little letters under their name, LLB, means little lying bastard. But there was this lawyer, and he got on a plane one day and he had a big box of frozen crabs, and he handed it to this blonde air hostess, and he said, "Please can you look after these crabs, and if anything happens to them you're going to be in a lot of trouble because I'm a lawyer." Anyway, they got towards the end of the flight, and the air hostess, she grabbed the intercom and she said, "Could the lawyer who gave me the crabs in New Orleans please raise his hand?" And nobody put their hand up. So she took the crabs home and ate them, and she had cheesecake with it as well, by the way. And it